Good afternoon. Welcome to the state capitol. It will be a busy place this time next week, but I appreciate you being here today. We have three judges to be sworn into office this afternoon. And we will proceed in the order of the Superior Court Judgeship for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit, the Superior Court Judgeship for the Clayton Judicial Circuit, and the State Court Judgeship for Clayton County. At the beginning, I want to welcome the justices of the Supreme Court. I see Justice Namias, who is here, and any judges of the Court of Appeals who might be here as well. Thank you for being here. To local judges and local courthouse officials from the respective areas of our state who are here for this ceremony, thank you all for being here as well. The first order of business is the introduction of my selection for the judicial post of Superior Court Judge of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. For purposes of introducing the soon-to-be judge is my good friend, the Honorable David Ralston, Speaker of the Georgia House of Representatives, a gentleman that I have had the pleasure and the opportunity of serving with during the entire time I have been the governor of this state. Speaker Ralston, the platform is yours.
Thank you very much, Governor, and members of the judiciary that are here. It was in the spring of 2010, I received a phone call from a young lawyer that I had the pleasure of meeting a number of times over the years. And he was calling to ask my advice about running for political office. Well, I talked him out of that. And I talked him into coming to work as a lawyer in my law practice. And today, that young lawyer is embarking on a new and exciting chapter in his life as he takes the oath of office as a Superior Court Judge for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. I am confident that Clint Bearden will bring the same qualities to the bench that he has demonstrated as a lawyer: a steady hand, a sharp legal mind, a strong desire to serve his community, and the ability to touch lives in a positive way. The decisions of a judge are far-reaching and profound. That is why we insist on our judges having the highest standards of integrity, fairness, impartiality, and an absolute commitment to adhering to the rule of law and doing justice. Governor Deal, you have chosen well. I have observed carefully the work and values of Clint Bearden. I know he will bring honor to the bench. I am confident that he will make the right and just call, regardless of how tough those decisions may be. It is a real honor for me at this time to present to you Judge Designate for the Northeastern Judicial Circuit, my friend, Clint Bearden.
If you will raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I can hear you.
Do solemnly swear, that I have been a resident of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit.
That I have been a resident of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit.
For the time required by law. That I will administer justice.
That I will administer justice.
Without respect to person.
Without respect to person.
And do equal rights to the poor and rich. And that I will faithfully and impartially. Discharge and perform. All the duties incumbent on me. As judge of the superior courts of this state. According to the best of my ability and understanding. And agreeably to the laws and constitution of this state.
And
the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
As I'm thinking about being here today, as over the last few days and with the new year, a lot of serious thought has gone on in my mind. It's a great opportunity that lies ahead, a great chance to do a lot of positive things. And in a moment of kind of lightheartedness, I was thinking that it's a good start to the new year when the Georgia Bulldogs winning the Rose Bowl is the second best thing that's happened this year. So I just say that I'm honored to be here this day, and with Governor Deal swearing me in would be an understatement. The work of Governor Deal, the legacy of what he and his team, the members of the General Assembly under Speaker Ralston, and the members of the House and Senate, judges and their staffs across the state that have worked over the last 7-8 years to advance accountability courts and to help create drastic change for the positive in our state's legal system and our state's criminal justice system. That's been the inspiration for me to be here today. I've sit through drug court graduations and health court graduations, and I laugh and I cry and I leave with the revival of my soul, because that's everything that's good about law, and the ability to have a positive influence upon people's lives and to help improve the lives of those in their community. I'm grateful for the chance to do that today. Grateful for the folks that have helped me be here, helped me achieve this. Speaker Ralston, you have been the greatest mentor and you've been the greatest friend, and I am forever loyal and forever grateful for what you've been able to help me, guide me. I hope that I have a small fraction of the wisdom and the patience and the sage counsel that you've been able to give over the years. Thank you very much. To the judges of the Appalachian Circuit, Judge Worcester and Judge Weaver are here. I don't know if Judge Priest and Judge Mercier, I think, is tied up in oral argument. She was one of our judges. You have been a great influence upon my life. I appreciate the wisdom that you've shared as a young lawyer to help guide me and help me become a better attorney. To the judges of the Northeastern Circuit and to the staff, I am beyond excited to go to work. The Northeastern Circuit is one of the greatest judicial circuits in the state of Georgia. They have had a history of some of the most well-respected judges, and that continues to be true today. Judge Fuller, Judge Goslin, Judge Oliver, Judge Deal, it's a pleasure to be able to work with you and to be able to learn from you. And I'm beyond excited to get to work on Monday morning with criminal pleas. I'm ready to go. To my friends that are here, certainly not lost upon me that I have met so many great friends over the years in my life. There's no way that that's been left to chance. I feel very firmly and believe that God has guided me in my life, and along the way he has placed some wonderful people that I'm glad to call friends today. You all inspire me. I have so many friends that have accomplished so much, and I know that they're going to go on to continue to accomplish great things. I'm grateful to call you friends. I'm grateful for your support, and I'm proud to have you here with me today. Lastly, I want to thank my family. I couldn't be here today without my mom and dad, who have worked so hard to provide for my sister and myself. They always strove to make sure that our life was better than their life, to make sure that we had the opportunities for education, to be able to go to college and to achieve our dreams. And I'm grateful for them. Grateful for my sister and brother-in-law that are here, my mother-in-law that's here. I have a wonderful extended family, aunts and uncles and cousins, that I've been blessed to be able to grow up with my entire life and have involved in my life. And I am so thankful for them. Most importantly, I'm thankful for my wife. She is the love of my life. And she has been, we've been together for 15 years, married for 11 and a half. And every night I go to bed, and I'm thankful in my prayers that God has blessed me with her in my life. She is a wonderful mother to our children, and the children are the highlight of our lives. I know every day to be able to come home from the stresses of a law practice and from the stresses of court and trying to do the best for your clients and trying to do the best for justice, to walk in and have your children run up to you and give you a hug is about the best therapy that I could ever imagine. So I'm grateful to have my family, the support, and I'm excited to go to work. I'm thankful for this opportunity and ready to hit the ground running. Thank y'all so much.
Thank you.
Well, Judge Bearden, I have it on good advice that the judges of this circuit are waiting for you to get there, and you won't have to worry about an agenda. They already have it ready and printed on your desk. Since we have three, we're going to do the photographs at the conclusion of the swearing-in ceremonies for the other two judges that remain. Well, I don't know about y'all, but I think after hearing from those three individuals that I've made some good choices. Don't you? There's something under here. Y'all just hold on. This is something that's under there. It's not what I was looking for. For those of you who have attended swearing-in ceremonies such as this before, you know that we have a tradition of presenting to the newly selected judges to give them a plaque with the appropriate gavel and an inscription of the day, etc., that commemorates this ceremony today. And I always tell the judges and remind them that these plaques are made by inmates in our state prison system. And I do that to remind you that you are to do justice. And even though there are those who do violate our laws, we wish they didn't, but they will and will continue to do so, unfortunately, that they all have some redeeming social values. And hopefully these plaques will remind you of that. Now we're going to move into the photograph section of this ceremony, and we'll do it in the order in which we proceeded with the swearing-ins. So for those of you who want to have photographs with Judge Bearden, if you will sort of move over here to the side and get ready for your time before the camera, and we will proceed in that order as we move through this process. Thank you again for everybody being here today.
Thank you. Today, Governor Nathan Deal swore in Clint Bearden as a Superior Court judge of the Northeastern Judicial Circuit. His action calls into question the entire judicial nominating process of the state of Georgia. Clint Bearden was the only nominee out of six who was opposed by the people of the state of Georgia, both as at the Judicial Nominating Commission and as well opposition directly to Governor Deal and his office. Nevertheless, Governor Deal swore him in today because of his political connections. Clint Bearden was the and is the law partner for Speaker of the House, David Ralston. He interned for Governor Deal when he was a U.S. Congressman, and he clerked for Governor Deal's son, Jason Deal, on the Superior Court bench. All of this calls into question the process of whether or not this is really a legitimate appointment. The people will have a chance to decide in 2 years when they will get a chance as to whether or not they want to elect Clint Bearden to this judgeship position.